But we begin with new details just released in the murder of an 82-year-old Zionsville man. This afternoon, police saying it appears John Clements' death was extremely random, and the case is one that the state could learn a big lesson from. The Now's Ann Kelly talking with the Zionsville police chief one-on-one just a bit ago. And Ann, Chief Knox is using this case to push for change.
That's right, Candace. Chief Knox and Boone County Prosecutor Todd Meyer, who I talked to on the phone minutes ago, telling me this case, what happened here in Zionsville, is proof that Indiana needs a new DNA collection law. But first, some background. Now, yesterday, Damian Wilkinson was arrested not just for the alleged murder of John Clements here in Zionsville, but also two recent IMPD headquarters shootings. At one of the IMPD headquarters shootings, there was also a note left behind which had DNA on it. That DNA was run through the system and a match found in Ohio, that of Wilcoxon. His DNA was on file because he was arrested for a felony in Ohio. He wasn't convicted there, but arrested. And in Ohio, that's all it takes for them to collect your DNA. Now, here in Indiana, where Wilcoxon has also been arrested for a felony, one has to actually be convicted to have their DNA put in the system. It's a law that Chief Knox says could have led to this 21-year-old getting away, never being linked to this murder in Zionsville.
I would like to see the state legislature take a serious look at changing our statutes to allow the collection of DNA anytime there's a felony arrest. Yeah. I think that would be a good thing, and I'm speaking there as a citizen and a police officer. It could lead to a lot of arrest and taking very dangerous people off the streets.
And Candace, the other update today, Wilcoxon with his first appearance before a judge, the murder suspect saying he wants to represent himself, but then quickly changing his mind. A public defender will be assigned to him and will join him on his next court date on December 23rd. Reporting live outside the Zionsville Police Department for the Now Indy, Ann Kelly, RTV6.
The victim's family issued this statement about the investigation today, saying they're relieved and thankful to investigators involved, saying, quote, their diligent work brought this to a quick resolution so that others would not be harmed. The family is also thanking their friends and neighbors who were able to provide information to investigators.